but goddamn, I wanna say some. She a dime, wanna make her mind. Heard through the grapevine, she a great time. Yeah, it should be a goddamn crime. Hi all, and welcome to this review of the Wuzhi Audio Bluetooth power amplifier with 250 watt channels. It works on a range of 12 volts to 24 volts. I'll put a link in the description to this product. It comes in two bags. Okay, so I ordered from eBay. So have a look at the item there. It comes with everything you need. You get your little mini amplifier here. So you've got your four speaker channels, your power input, and your on-off volume control. Then in this pack, you get a pack of screws, some bases, and a little screwdriver. So this is just to build a nice little case for it. So it just lines up over there, just like so, for the bottom. Then place a screw through one of the holes, line it up, and place your little gold bar on top, just your little height adjuster, screw it down, and then when you've done that, I've got one I've already assembled, so I'm just going to do this quick. When you line up the top board as well, you just can do the same, line up the hole with the risers you put in place, place the screw in, using the supplied screwdriver, tighten it up. Now, if we look at this board, we can see that all the connections are marked out on it once it's in this nice little case. So what we're going to do, we're just going to unscrew that very quickly because I have built one of these already. So I purchased two of these, so it makes life a bit quicker. And let's just pop these back in the bag very quickly, just so we don't lose all the little tiny little screws. That would be a pain. That's all locked in there. So we just pop that one aside. So the one I purchased, I have a battery for it. Everything a bit tangled up here. It's a battery lead. And then here come two speakers. So I'm going to test this with some Pioneer TS-G1010F speakers. Just so you can see the connections that I've built in place. So as you can see, I've connected one speaker into the left channel, and one speaker into the right channel. Okay, so you just plug in your power lead. As you can see, it's connected to my mobile phone now. So we've got a blue status light, so it's connected. We've got volume control. When you turn it off, your status light goes off as well. Now, one thing I have noticed is that as much as that is now turned off and that Bluetooth light's gone on, Bluetooth module in here is still working, so it's still drawing power. So when you wire this in, I'd make sure you wire in a switch onto your positive line to cut the power to it and purely use this as an on-off switch. So I'm going to turn it to about this position. I'm going to grab my mobile phone. I'm going to open up YouTube. There we go. And I'm going to search for Neffex. Okay. Now, he makes royalty free music. There's a link to his channel in my description as well. His channel just here. So let's just give me any song by him. Let's pick his channel. Yes, it's quite a good song. So as you can see, we're connected up, so I'm just going to turn the volume up on my phone. Now that volume there, that's at about 30% of the dial on the control, so I'm just going to turn it up a bit more to about 50%, and we hit play again. Now, as you can see, then I moved the speakers. You can see a bit of the movement on them. They are quite loud. That's only at about 50% volume. There's a little bit of distortion, but they're actually from the speakers because they're not in an enclosure at the moment, and they're quite raw as well. So yeah, it's nice and loud. This is only running at 12 volts at the moment, I should add. If you took it to 24 volts, it does go, well, obviously it goes louder, but most applications for this that I'd see, most people are going to be running it at 12 volts anyway. It does go all the way down to 12 volts as well, so you could almost possibly run this off a USB power bank even. Yeah, it's a good little amplifier. I had it running for about an hour earlier on. Didn't really generate that much heat. So battery life, well, I guess it all depends on the capacity of your battery. This is a 10 amp hour battery that I've been testing with, and it's held up okay. So yeah, it's a nice, good, sturdy amplifier. It feels well built. Connections are good. So you do get your DC jack input line. I just temporarily connect it into some Scotch blocks just for testing, purely for testing. I wouldn't recommend you leave it like this. You don't get any speaker wire with it. You get your screwdriver to build your case up, but you do need a mini flathead screwdriver, Stanley, I believe it's called actually, for doing your speaker connections in. Just tighten them up and loosen them up. That's about it really. You can pop the volume control knob off if you're gonna be putting this, knocked the camera, haven't I? Whoops. Oh, there you go, that's better. Right, knocked it again. So you can always take this off if you're mounting this into an enclosure or anything and you want that out on display. Just pops straight off and then push it back on when you want to adjust. Okay, I'm going to be installing this into Powerwheels Kids Ride-On car. So hit that subscribe button. You'll see the video coming soon. If you like this video, please hit the like. Thank you very much. Goodbye.